I'm recording now. Can you give me that mic, Ray?
Yeah. Now I'll leave this mic on, then I'll turn their mic on.
Yeah. Right, and you're going to just hand me that, are you?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you're sitting over there.
You're sitting here, yeah. You're not caught around a table leg or anything, are you?
No.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you need it?
No.
Okie dokie, right, so here we are, we're on Bootboy Radio, we're on Subcultz Radio, and we're on what's the other one?
Scar Express
in Ireland. So we're already collaborating around the world. And what we've got today is we've got the legendary Beat from Birmingham. We're up in Dudley at the moment, so they're a local band. So if we can introduce yourself. So at first we've got
Everett Morton.
And you're an original member,
Everett? Original member, yes.
From when did the band
begin? From the start.
Which year was that?
1979.
79, yeah?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. That's given away.
What? Oh, no. Okay, let's start again. Right, so here we are with Bootboy Radio, with Subcultz Radio, and with Scar Express in Ireland. And we've got the legendary Beat with us, with Everett
Morton, who started from 1979, from the start of it.
Okay, and you're based up in Birmingham, weren't you?
Yes.
Which is the British Midlands. And who else have we got?
Yeah, I'm Mickey Billingham. I joined the Beat in about 2007, I think it was. One of the later incarnations of it. And I live in Dudley at the moment.
And what was your history as a musician?
Well, before that, I was in when the Beat split up originally, one of the offshoot bands was called General Public, so I joined them. And before that, I used to play for Dex's Midnight Runners.
Okay, and Dex's and the Beat, you were in the sort of circle of...
There was a lot of rivalry. Yeah. Kevin hated he hated all the two-tone thing.
Right, okay.
He didn't want to be part of it.
Yeah, he thought it was just like another fad.
Really? Yeah. So what was his inspiration then? Why was he...
Well, he was more into soul and stuff like that. James Brown coming from there, you know. He didn't really like reggae or ska.
Right. So it was more of a local rivalry type of thing, was it? Yeah.
I think it was very one-sided, though.
Yeah. It's interesting, because, I mean, where I grew up in Wickham, you know, two-tone and the Beat and, you know, that music you were doing, that just gelled us right from, you know, because we had a big sort of West Indian community and a big punk scene, and so that blended.
Oh, of course.
So, and we're not far really, you know, we're sort of west of London, we're not a million miles, but it was like real working class stuff, you know. So who's our third guest today?
The third guest is Deminus, the new recruit and the young recruit to the band.
And you, and what are you doing, Deminus?
I'm the front man.
You're the vocalist, aren't you?
Yeah.
Cool. And how many gigs have you done so far with the Beat?
It's only one so far.
Okay.
Which is a live stream charity gig for the Cancer Fund.
Right. And where are you from originally?
I'm originally from Jamaica.
Oh, okay. So you were born in Jamaica, were you?
Born in Jamaica.
Oh, okay. And you live now in Birmingham?
No, now living in Birmingham. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Cool. All right. So we got the real deal. We got the genuine articles here. So, shall we play a first track that they've chosen?
Yeah, which one?
Whichever one's on top of the list.
All right, here we go then.
If you tell us what the song is first, then we can see
Jimmy Cliff.
Jimmy Cliff, which song?
Many Rivers to Cross.
And who chose this?
Deminus.
Do you want to tell us why you chose this, Deminus?
Yeah, I chose this one because as a young child growing up in Jamaica, I always heard my granddad playing it. Because my granddad used to have a sound system. So this track was released 1969, and it's also released 1972, and it was also covered by UB40 and Percy Sledge.
Yeah.
So this is Jimmy Cliff, Many Rivers to Cross. Well done.
Choose one of Everett's. You've got the list, haven't you, of who chose what?
Yeah, but I'll be fine. I've got to listen in to make sure it's all coming through.
He's got my phone. There should be. You were sent a message with all the tracks on it.
Yeah.
With.
But I can't do three things on the phone. So So what I'll do, I'll do them in order.
What track would you want to play next, Everett? Something that you chose?
But my selection's not there, you haven't got it.
Oh, okay.
Did you
choose it?
Yeah.
Go on, we can have one
of
your songs.
Okay, Retro, Maxwell,
yeah. And then if you think of one that maybe Mick's got, that you can tell a little story about, maybe one of your early inspirations or something. We won't play them all at once, but it's just to provoke conversation.
I can show him my phone and see if he's got any.
Yeah.
You can see if you've got any of them there.
So just one question to you, really, guys. Is in Jamaica now, how is sort of ska and reggae? Is it still played there? Is it still appreciated by the people living in Jamaica, or is it more of a sort of yesterday's news?
It is more or less like a yesterday's news, and I'm so appreciated that I'm here where I can appreciate Jamaican music of my own. You know what I'm saying? It is more dancehall, sort of, because you know they like to go with the head of the time.
Yeah.
So it's not like they throw it away. When it comes around, they'll appreciate it. But like how the outside world embrace ska music is more appreciated. So I'm kind of in that sort of group. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So what track have you chosen, Everett?
I've chosen Money in My Pocket by Dennis Brown.
And why have you chosen that song?
Why, Miko? I've got money in my pocket.
That's quite a simple answer, isn't it? Yeah. Okay.
Kansas.
Oh, okay. What year was that music? Dillinger, wasn't it?
I can't remember what year it was, but I mean, it's always stuck with me. For money in my pocket, can't get no loving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was that sort of before sort of the two-tone era? Or was that more
it was before.
Oh, it was, yeah.
Before, yeah.
Yeah, because I never, like a lot of the reggae, because it would that, what would that be classed as? Is that more dancehall, that style of reggae? Or?
It would be, yeah.
Yeah.
Rock steady.
Yeah, because I always get confused.
Demi knows, thanks for answering for me, because I mean,
he knows his stuff. You need a young brain.
Exactly, a young brain.
So money in my pocket, I mean, that's quite a profane thing, really, with music, because obviously a lot of early musicians were ripped off, weren't they? A lot of the early Motown.
I mean, probably that's why he singing money in my pocket, you know, he can't get no loving, he can't get no more of it, and I think that's what it is.
And so what was your story with the beat? Because you were with Go Feet,
yes. My story was with the beat to me. Look, my girlfriend says, there's some guys want a drummer. And I went to see what they was talking about. And look, it was very, very punky.
Yeah.
Punky. I was playing reggae from the start. And then I went and... But today people say, oh, with the beat, this beat now sounds like... reggae.
Right.
But I was playing reggae, and because I'm a bit older now, you know, they've got me going fast, but now I've gone back down to reggae. Right. I've always been playing reggae, but it was like a fast punk.
So how did it, with the Birmingham sort of punk and reggae scene at the time, was it a real mixture of everybody in the same clubs and bars, or was it quite separate?
It was.
And what everyone was like working together.
Down in the cellars, like you go down there with blues and you listen to all this type of music. Like, I think that's what gets me interested in playing music or playing the drums.
Yeah. And so Go Feet Records, was that, who was that? That was our label,
because, you know, Special did the two-tone, so we're thinking, oh, we better name a label, like, so we had Go Feet.
Yeah.
But we've only had about probably two, I think one of us song came out in it, then we had the, what the band called, we had the, because they worked with us, and so we had them on the label, but it didn't last for long. We went to the bigger label, who can give us money. Yeah.
And so with Two Tone, because obviously Two Tone's Coventry and Birmingham is Go Feet.
Yes.
And to anyone who doesn't know, Birmingham and Coventry are very near each other.
Very close. People think the beat was from Coventry.
Yeah.
But we had them mind, but I don't care where it came from.
And how was the scene then? Was there a rivalry between Birmingham and Coventry, or was it together?
It was together.
Yeah.
Yeah, we would say it was together. Yeah.
So in the long run, then, with your own label there, you obviously got yourself all registered and you're all, you know, like legally all bound and everything. So everybody
give us a start.
Did you get your writing credits in later life? Is it worked out well for you?
Oh, you work out fantastic.
Yeah, great. So you had
I've got nothing bad to say about it.
Brilliant.
So that's
in your pocket. Money in your pocket.
But no loving.
None of us got no loving, baby. Nothing changes there. Yeah. Right, so let's choose another track then from our fella here. So say what?
Yeah, I've selected Wet Dream by Max Romeo. I first heard that track when I was about 10 and I'd never heard anything as outrageous. But the thing that sold it for me was the organ solo in the middle. That's genius, that is.
So here we are, Mick's going to play that for us. Go to bed.